Let's talk about high-speed transmit capture capability offered by wireless Testbench. This feature enables transmit capture to 250 mega samples per second. It also provides optimized data I/O between MATLAB and supported USRP hardware. You can transform the connected radio into baseband receiver, baseband transmitter, and baseband transceiver operating at full device rates. The use cases and applications of baseband receiver is to capture signals such as 5G, LTE, satellite, and custom signals from the air. The baseband transmitter can be used to transmit custom or standard-based waveforms, transmit noise or interfering waveforms. The baseband transceiver can be used to analyze channel effects such as signal attenuation and multipath, assess the performance of radio hardware and analog frontends. The transceiver also enables loopback workflows. This figure is a high-level representation of the baseband receiver. You can create a baseband receiver by specifying the name of the radio configuration. The baseband receiver can be used to capture baseband samples from the air. The captured data is buffered in the onboard RAM of the supported USRP hardware to ensure contiguous and high-speed data capture. Baseband receiver supports full range of sample rates supported by USRP hardware. The baseband receiver provides a capture function to capture baseband samples from the air. This function also monitors if samples are dropped during the capture. The code shows how you can use baseband receiver to capture 3 milliseconds of data at the set sample rate. This diagram shows the baseband transmitter provided by wireless Testbench. You can easily convert a supported USRP radio into a baseband transmitter from MATLAB and configure the specified radio to transmit baseband samples to the air. The transmitter uses onboard RAM to achieve high-speed transmission. You can configure continuous or single-shot transmission from MATLAB. The baseband transmitter provides transmit and stop transmit functions. The code here shows how you can transmit a specified sample rate for 5 seconds and then stop the transmission. This figure shows the high-level architecture of the baseband transceiver. You can easily create an object of baseband transceiver in MATLAB to simultaneously transmit and capture IQ waveforms over the air. The baseband transceiver also uses onboard RAM to operate at maximum sample rates that are up to 250 mega samples per second. You can configure continuous or single-shot transmission. The baseband transceiver provides transmit, capture, and stop transmission functions. The code shows how you can use a baseband transceiver for loopback workflows. You can transmit a random signal and capture it into MATLAB workspace. Let me show you some examples to demonstrate high-speed data I/O capability offered by wireless Testbench. This example shows the baseband receiver's capability to capture a signal from the air in specified frequency band. Firstly, we provide the name of the radio configuration that user can set during the USRP radio setup. You can refer to the product page or documentation and look for simple radio setup to know more about configuring the radio with MATLAB. Then, we specify the frequency band that we wish to capture. In this case, the selected band is allocated for FM radio. Next, we configure the baseband receiver and set the RF properties such as sample rate, center frequency, radio gain, and antennas. Then, we invoke the capture method to capture 1 second of data. Finally, we plot the spectrum of the captured data using the spectrum analyzer. One can see that whole FM frequency band is visible. The vertical red lines in the spectrogram are FM radio stations. You can demodulate and listen to any one of these FM stations. In this example, we will capture using multiple antennas from a specified frequency band. Using multiple antennas, you can capture a wider frequency band by setting different center frequencies for different channels. Firstly, we set the name of the radio connected to MATLAB. Then, we specify the frequency band that is from 470 MHz to 694 MHz that is used for TV broadcasting, which is 224 MHz wide spectrum. Next, we set the RF properties such as antenna array, center frequency for each channel, sample rate, and radio gain. The sample rate and center frequency are set as each channel will contain one half of the spectrum of interest. Then, we capture the signal for 100 milliseconds using capture function. The capture function returns the data matrix where the two columns correspond to the two channels. Next, we resample the captured data and shift the spectrum to plot the complete frequency band together as each channel will contain one half of the spectrum of interest. Finally, we plot the spectrum using the spectrum analyzer, and one can see the complete 224 MHz wide spectrum used for TV broadcasting. In this example, you'll see how the baseband transceiver can be used in loopback to transmit a signal and receive it on the same radio. Firstly, we choose the radio that is connected to MATLAB. Next, we load a known waveform from a file that will be transmitted over the air. In this example, I have chosen a sine wave. Then we create baseband transceiver object. Next, we set the RF properties such as sample rate, that is corresponding to the sampling frequency of the waveform to be transmitted, transmit center frequency, that specifies where in frequency spectrum our signal will be transmitted, capture center frequency, it's same as transmit center frequency, and radio gains. Then we transmit the waveform continuously. Next, we invoke the capture function to capture for the specified duration of data. The capture function returns a column vector that should contain our signal. Then we stop the transmission. Finally, we use spectrum analyzer to plot frequency spectrum of the received data, and one can see the peak that corresponds to my signal, that was a sinusoid. You can refer to the product page to know more about high-speed data I/O feature and other capabilities offered by wireless Testbench. You can also see the documentation for getting started guide and tutorials.